Okay, so today we're going to take a look at the NeoPixel Library. Now, this is a stripped down version of the simple sketch that's in the NeoPixel Library example sketch folder. For the full guide, you should really check out Adafruit's Uber guide for NeoPixels. But for now, this is enough to get us started. So we've used libraries before when we used the serial library. This time we had to actually download and install the NeoPixel library because it doesn't come pre-installed with Arduino. And we need this line up here, which is going to include that into our Arduino sketch. Now, there are lots of libraries we could include, but our Arduino has limited memory space. So what we do is we only put these lines in when we want to add them into our sketch so that we don't use up memory space that we don't actually need to do. All right, now we've got something else I want to draw your attention to. So we see define pin 6 and define numpixels 12. All right, this is a little bit different. So in the past, what we've done is we've done something like int pin equal 6, right? And we've done that all in lowercase. This is when we declare a variable. The difference being here, what we are doing is we're declaring a constant. So the word pin is never going to change its value. So when we did LED pin and we incremented it so we could change the value of LED pin, we knew we might change it. So we used just a regular variable. So with define, we are declaring a constant. So the word pin is a constant. Now, by convention, when we declare a constant, we do it all in uppercase. We don't have to use all uppercase letters. But as a convention, so that when we know we're talking about a constant, we do that. And you'll also notice there's no semicolon at the end of our define line, our hashtag define line, okay? So this is saying define the constant pin and give it a value of 6. And then we're saying define the constant numpixels as 12. In this case, we're doing 12 because our NeoPixel ring has 12 pixels. Now, we don't want to ever change the value of pin or numpixels because our physical NeoPixel always going to be plugged into pin 6 once we start our program, and our ring only has 12 pixels. All right, so that's why we're using the hashtag define. You could, if you wanted to, say int pin equals 6 and int numpixels equals 12 and use them just as well as long as you don't change the value of those. All right, so that's the one change we had to see. Now, the next thing we need to draw your attention to is here. This is where we are invoking an instance of the Adafruit library, okay? So we're gonna create an instance called pixels. Now this could literally be, this pixels could literally be any word, all right? We're just calling it pixels here. Now if you change it, let's say you wanted to call it pixels ring, you could do that, but anywhere else where pixels appears in the program, you would have to change it to pixels ring, okay? So it's called pixels because that's the name we gave it. Just like any variable, we could give it a name and it can be any name we want. All right, so when we invoke pixels, when we invoke the pixel library, we're going to have three arguments. Our first argument is the number of LEDs that we're attaching to the Arduino in this NeoPixel string. The second argument, so this clearly that's why we put numpixels there. The second one is a number again, and this is the pin that we're going to be using with our NeoPixel. Not so bad, right? Now the last argument, this one's a little different, okay? So I really couldn't tell you what all the pieces of this mean. I just put it in and it works. The only thing to know is that sometimes if the colors don't work out right, rather than GRB, we make it Neo underscore RGB. So my NeoPixel rings work with GRB, and the NeoPixel strips you get from Adafruit would work with GRB. But if you get the individual NeoPixels that you can stick in a breadboard, those are probably going to be RGB. If you're not sure, go ahead and fire it up. The only thing that'll happen is the colors won't be right. And then go back and change this to RGB and try it again, and then your colors will probably be good. So that's the only thing to know with that one. So again, you got three arguments. The first argument is the number of pixels. So if you had a different ring or a different number of pixels, this would be a different number. This is the pin you have it plugged into on your Arduino, and then leave this one exactly like this, except occasionally changing it to be that one. All right, not so bad. Now, this next bit, delay val, we know what that is. We're just creating a variable. And then in our setup, just like when we did serial.begin, we need to do pixels dot begin. So this is saying take our object pixels that we created up here and start it up. Get it ready to do something. Nothing's going to happen yet. We're just saying make it ready. All right. So we only have to do that once, so we put that in our setup. All right. Then down here we've got a for loop, and we're going to go for I equals 0, because we're going to start at 0, and we're going to go through num pixels. Now, our pixels, we have 12 NeoPixels on our ring, and they are numbered from 0 through 11. So there are 12 pixels, 0 through 11. So the first one is 0, not 1. Pretty typical in computer programming to start with 0. So we then come to our next function that we need to worry about, which is pixels set pixel color. This is going to set the color of a pixel. I know, truth in advertising. So we've got two arguments inside our pixel set color. The first argument is I, well, that's a number, right? And that's the pixel number. So this is the which pixel we want. Which pixel are we going to light up? That's the first one. That's the first argument. The second argument is our color. All right, so fairly straightforward. Which pixel, so again, starting at 0 and going through 11, and then the second one is what color do we want to make it? And again, we're going to do pixels.color. And again, if we changed, let's say we didn't use pixels, but we used pixels ring, that pixels would have to be pixels ring. All right, so whatever the name is that you invoked, that's the same name you're going to use everywhere pixels appears in this sketch. So you set the color, and the colors are RGB. So we talk about RGB color scheme, and that's red, green, blue. So how much red are we going to add, how much green are we going to add, and how much blue are we going to add? This is just like back in the fading LEDs where we had any values from 0 through 255 that we can write for red, and we can write 0 to 255 for green, and we can write 0 to 255 for blue. And with those combinations of different brightnesses, we can make any color of light that we want to make. So we set the color. So in this case, we have no red, we have green at 150, and we have no blue. Now remember, we can go all the way up to 255. These are pretty bright, so 150 is still pretty bright, you'll notice. So this will be a green color, but not as bright as we possibly could get. All right, not so bad. So we're going to set. So what we're doing in our for loop is we start at 0, so we take 0 and we set it to green. All right, and then we've got this line, pixels.show. So set it to green doesn't actually change it to be green. What it says is, hey you, number 0, get ready to be green. That's all we're doing. When we say set pixel color, we're just sending a command. We're saying get ready and hold on to this idea, which is I want to be green. When I do pixels.show, that says, all right, all you pixels in the ring, whatever color that I've told you last to be, do that now. That's what pixels.show means. Not so bad, right? So we light up all our pixels, then we wait, and then we come around, now it's 1, and we say, hey, 1, get ready to be green. And then we say, hey, all pixels, show me your color. Not so bad, right? So if you don't do pixels.show, you will see no change, all right? And the other thing to realize is it's whatever the last thing that you told that pixel to do, that's what's going to be shown. So if you say, hey you, pixel 0, become green, and then you say, hey you, pixel 0, become blue, when I say pixels.show, it's just going to be blue. We'll never actually see the green, all right? That's important to know. So with those two commands, you can do a lot of stuff with your NeoPixels. You can fade them. You know how to do fading. You just take that same idea of fading that we did when we did the analog write, and you can do it with NeoPixels. You can sequence them. You can have one light up after the other. You can flash all of them at the same time. You can slowly fade from one color into another. So what I want you to do now is I want you to play for a bit with the NeoPixel ring, now that you understand the basics of how it works.